Hi there. I've had a lot of people ask me how I wash my hair in space, and I thought I'd show you how I do it.
Let's see. To get started, these are the things I need. A bag of warm water, a little no-rinse shampoo, towel, and my comb. What I like to do is start by just putting some hot water, squirting it onto my scalp. And I have a mirror here so I can kind of watch what I'm doing. Sometimes the water gets away from you and you try and catch as much as you can. Then I just work the water up through to the ends of my hair. Then I take my no-rinse shampoo and squirt it also on the scalp, just a little bit, and rub it in. Again, kind of working it out to the ends. And sometimes I'll actually take my comb to help work it all the way to the ends. And I like to take my towel while I have the shampoo in there and just kind of work it. Because without standing under running water, you kind of need to use the towel a little bit to help get some of the dirt out. I like to follow that by a little more water. It's called no rinse shampoo, but I think it's best if you use a little water with it. Actually feels kind of squeaky clean right now. Now I'll take the dry part of my towel. We used towels for quite a while here since we have limited supplies. We use them wisely. There, I think that's pretty good. And now as my hair dries, as the water evaporates from my hair, it will become humidity in the air, and then our air conditioning system will collect that into condensate, and it won't be long, and our water processing system will turn that into drinking water. At the end, I just do one final comb through to make sure there are no snarls and snags, and while it dries, I like to let it stay free. I don't put it back in a ponytail while it's drying. And that is how I wash my hair in space on the International Space Station.
So the answer is, we have a great variety of food up here.
Two different general types of food, thermostabilized food, and these green packets that's very similar to military MREs, or meals ready to eat. And then we also have freeze-dried food.
So all of the water content has been sucked out. This is just basic asparagus, so we need to add the water back in. We want to make sure all that water is mixing in, and then we usually put it here inside the food warmer.
And then we have refrigerated space here. They've been nice enough to allow us to use these just for food. All right,
dinner table. Some Turkish fish stew. I have butternut squash.
All right, and I'm having, I have rice with butter, some lentil soup, and grilled chicken patty. A lot of the Russian food comes in cans. This was one of my favorites. This is spicy beef and rice.
Space makes eating a lot more fun. You can turn your spoon upside down or even let it go, and nothing's gonna fall off. You can eat in any direction. You can eat upside down if I want to.
So here's a common question. Can you cry in space? Do tears work? Well, let's try it out. I can't cry on command, but I'm gonna take some water, drinking water, put it in my eye just as if I was crying. Let's see what happens. Get myself nice and stable for you here. Here we go. So, just as if I started crying, my eye is full of tears. But you can see it just forms a ball on my eye. In fact, I can put more water in. And so if you keep crying, you just ended up with a bigger and bigger ball of water in your eye, until eventually it crosses across your nose and gets into your other eye, or evaporates, or maybe spreads over your cheek, or you grab a towel and dry it up. So yes, I've gotten things in my eye, Your eyes will definitely cry in space, but the big difference is tears don't fall. So grab a hanky.